how are you all? I hope that you're very good. You had a good time. You had a great time during your summer vacation, during your summer break. I hope everyone of you enjoyed a lot, right? The summer break was very refreshing for you all because it was very refreshing for me. So I hope that it was the same for you. We are back with the online classes. We are back with the videos. We are back with the assignments. And I didn't expect complaints. Many of you did good job. You performed well. You did the assignments on time. Everything was on time. But many of you did not respond. You did not respond. You did not receive the calls, right? I called few of you. The calls weren't there. The numbers were not there. So these were the things that are going in the same manner, and we should not go in that manner. So I request every one of you to please be particular, please be punctual in whatever thing is given to you, right? Next thing, your examinations are around the corner. They are going to start very, very soon, and I hope and I wish that every one of you is ready, is prepared, well prepared for the examinations, right? The examinations will start from, I think, by the end of July, we have your first terminal examinations, which are important. They contain marks. Also, the assignments, they contain marks. So, if you have not sent the assignments, they're not proper, they're not in the manner to be sent to the teacher, please prepare them in the proper manner, right? Now, moving back to the chapters, moving back to the syllabus, we have done 4 to 5 chapters we have already done. Productive mechanism, land, labor, efficiency of labor, capital we have done demand. The question paper will be formed from all these chapters only. So I want you to read these chapters. I want you to do the homework, because the homework will also help you a lot in understanding the topics. Watch the videos if you haven't watched. Till the time you will not do all these things, you might not get good marks in the examinations. Now we will start with a new chapter today, and that is chapter number, I'm not saying the chapter number, right? Because this is a new book. Those who have the old book, you might have some other chapter numbers. But we are starting with theory of supply, right? So today we are going to start with a new chapter, that is supply, theory of supply. Quantity, and you will have means that you will have a quantity that will be given to you, so that you can present it in the market on a given price, right? The prices can differ from one commodity to another commodity, but they might not be so much different that there is a huge difference. So like 1 or 2 rupees difference may be there. So supply is what? Supply means it is the quantity which is available with a given amount of price for the given time period. Right? Now next we'll do is law of supply. Now like we have done law of demand. We have law of supply. Now, like we have the law of demand, we have law of supply. Now, what does law of supply say? It says that when the prices increases, the supply also increases. Right? And when the prices decreases, the supply also decreases. Right? Says that when the prices are, this is law of supply. Law of supply says that when the prices are increases, so the supply also increases, and then when prices decreases, supply also decreases. So what we have is over here we have a direct relationship. Right? We have a direct relationship between what? We have direct relationship between supply. That law of supply says that as the prices of a commodity will increase, the supply of that commodity will also increase in the market, and as the prices of that particular commodity will decrease, the supply also of that commodity will decrease. Now this says, these arrows, they define the relationship between the prices and supply, that is between the prices and supply, and it says that they have a direct relationship. Right? They have a direct relationship. In demand, in law of demand, in theory of demand, we did indirect relationship, where it was that when the prices were increasing, the demand was going down, and when the prices were going down, the demand was increasing. But over here we have a direct relationship between the supply and the prices, which says that when the prices are increasing, the supply will also increase of a commodity. It can be particular, it can be a common, it can be specific, it can be anything. And when the prices of that commodity is decreasing, the supply also of the commodities will decrease in the market in a particular time period. Right? Now moving on to the diagrammatic representation of this law. Now what we have done in demand. In demand, we have studied about the relationship between the prices and demand, and it was an indirect relationship, and we formed the diagrams. We were forming the curves according to that. Now, over here in direct relationship between the prices and supply, what happens is that how we are going to form a curve. Now, this is your OX axis, and that is your OY axis. Always the prices will be shown on the OY axis and the quantity will be shown on the X axis, on the OX axis. Now in demand we were taking a term that was QTY demanded. QTY demanded, which was quantity demanded. Right? Same term will be there, but over here it will be supplied. Right? It will be supplied. So it will be that quantity supplied. So OX axis will always show the quantity supplied, and OY axis will always show the prices. Now, if the prices were P1, Okay, if the prices were P1, the commodity will be Q1. Now, if the prices supposedly are increasing from P1 to, they are decreasing from P1 to P, so the quantity will also decrease from Q1 to Q, right? Now, the prices will increase from P1 to P2, say. Now, the quantity will also increase from Q1 to Q2. Now, this is a, these are the supply curves, and these curves represent a direct relationship between the prices and between the quantity supplied, which says that when the prices will increase, the quantity demanded will also increase. And when the prices will decrease, the quantity demanded will also decrease. So you can clearly see a decrease in the, you can clearly see a decrease. I will tell you, I'll explain you once again that supposedly prices were P1. Okay. And quantity supplied is Q1. Now the prices have decreased from P1 to P, so my quantity supply will also decrease from Q to Q1 to Q. Now, if there is a further increase in the prices, which is from P1 to P2, so my quantity supply will also increase from Q1 to Q2, which says that as the prices are increasing, the supply, quantity supplied is also increasing, right? It says that when the prices are increasing, the quantity supplied is also increasing, and when the prices are decreasing, the quantity supplied is also decreasing. Right, so this is very clear, this is very simple, and the curves will be always straight line curves. Okay, like in demand, the curves were like this. Okay, the curve was like this, it was a downward sloping curve, but over here it is an upward sloping curve, because the higher the curve is away from the origin, it means the higher the supply is, right? So this is what, this is law of supply. So the law of supply says that there is a direct relationship between what? There is a direct relationship between the prices and the quantity supplied. As the prices of a commodity will increase, the supply will also increase, and as the prices of certain commodity will decrease, the supply of that commodity will also decrease. This was a simple, clear supply curves. These are the supply curves. You can donate them by SS. You can donate this by S1 and this by S2. Right? So these are the curves which shows the relationship between the prices and the commodities, right? So we have done two topics over here in this chapter, that was meaning of supply and the law of supply. So the meaning of supply, I have already told you that what is the meaning of supply. Supply means that quantity for a particular commodity which a seller is ready to sell at a given price. So supply is what? Like we did demand. Demand was what? Demand was that it is the commodity that the purchase, that the buyers or the consumers are ready to buy at a certain price, at a certain amount. So in the same manner, supply is what? Supply is also the amount of a commodity. Right? Supply is also what? Supply is also the amount of a commodity which is presented in the market at a particular price, right? And the sellers are ready to sell it on that given price in the market, right? Demand is a consumer related concept and supply is a seller related concept. Supply, law of supply is related to suppliers, it is related to the sellers, whereas demand is related to the consumers, it is related to the buyers, right? So supply is what? Supply is a seller related concept. A question can be asked that what concept is supply and what concept is demand. So supply is a seller related concept and demand is a consumer related concept. So these were the two topics that we have done, and I hope that this was clear to you. Go through the books. If you do not have the books, you can Google it. I suggest you to have purchased books as soon as possible, right? But if it is creating a problem for you to find the books, then Google all these terms. It is there, and try to get it into your head, because this is important, right? So we have done two topics in this video, that was supply, meaning of supply, and the law of supply, and I hope that this was clear to you. And the videos will be given to you. Do not take these for granted. Again, I am saying that these are very important. I want you to please watch them, because we are making it by our heart. We are doing a lot of efforts in making these videos for you, right? I hope you enjoyed it. It was clear to you, and we'll catch up in the next session. Till then, take care.